Welcome to today's video. Today we are finishing chapter 3 if you are following the book Vámonos. This topic should be easy and we call it adjetivos demostrativos. Now, very important. When you use an adjetivo demostrativo, you have to be able to signal what you are pointing out. You have to move your hands, your lips, your eyes, your head, something. You cannot speak like without any emotions when you are using these adjetivos demostrativos. That's why we call it demostrativos. You are demonstrating what you are referring to. That's the first thing. Second thing that is very important, we have three levels of distance. Meanwhile, in English, if I understand right, you only have two, this and that. In Español, we have three. Now, remember, like many things in Spanish, we have to agree with the gender and the number. So this is part of the thing that you have to learn today, all right? So let me write down the first one. And we have four, right? Because it's gender and number. So the first one is este, esta, remember, no acento, because it's not a verb, estos, and estas. This first level is for things that are close to you that you can touch. Right? And one more time, these are the masculine ones, these are the feminine ones, these are the singular, and these are the plurals. We will use the same structure in the second one. This is the equivalent to English, this, if I understand right. The next level is something that is close to you, but you cannot touch. The same logic, right? Masculine, feminine, singular, and plural. Ese, esa, esos, and esas. This is probably that in English, as well as that number three will be that as well. So we have numero uno, numero dos, the second level, right? Close to you, but you cannot touch. And numero tres, we will have the same logic, masculine, feminine, singular, and plural. We will have aquel, aquella, aquellos, and aquellas. This is far from you, but it still is visual. You have to be able to see it. If you are not able to see it, these adjetivos demostrativos doesn't work. I hope that you find this easy to remember and then very easy to apply. So let's do some sentences where you can put this object in place. So for the first sentence, for the first level, I will use feminine singular. I will say, esta chica, this girl, right, es Emily. Why esta? First of all, because chica is feminine, singular, and esta also because it's close to me that I can even touch. That's a simple example, right? And most of these sentences are very simple, by the way. So you shouldn't have any problems, right? Let's do sentence number two. Let's choose something masculine plural. Esos coches son nuevos. Right? That car. So they are they can be close to me, but I cannot touch them. And why esos? Because it's masculine plural, the noun that I'm using. Esos coches son nuevos. See that in the sentence, every single thing agree with the noun coches, plural, masculine. All right? Allow me to erase this so I can do number three. With sentence number three, I can choose masculine singular. Aquel chico es David. That boy over there is David, right? Why aquel? Because chico is masculine and is singular, right? And aquel also because it's far from where we are, but still you should be able to see what I am pointing out, the boy that I'm pointing out, you should be able to see, because if you cannot see, this sentence cannot work, all right? Now, I wanna give you a little bit of information here. At this point, you already know artículos determinados, el, la, los, las. You know artículos indeterminados, un, una, and so on. You already know the possessive adjectives, me, su, tu, etc. And now you are learning adjetivos demostrativos. What I want to caution you is this. In a sentence, let's say that I say estudiantes, and estudiantes can be neutral gender, right? Can be feminine or masculine. I want to start my sentence starting in this noun. Son inteligentes. Here, at the very beginning of the sentence, you need something, right? And what is that something that you need? You can use an article. You can say los estudiantes. You can also say las estudiantes because estudiantes is neutral gender. That's fine. If you choose that, that's correct. Those are artículos determinados. You can also use, but notice what I do. I have to erase this because in this spot that I have here, only one thing can fit this spot. It's like a parking lot. Only one space for many cars that are arriving. So you decide to use articles. You have to stay with that article. You cannot use the other thing. You can use an artículo indeterminado. Unos or unas. That's also possible. But you cannot use los or las. Right? You can use possessive. It's a little bit strange to use possessive, but you can use possessive, especially in my culture. Mis estudiantes son inteligentes. Now, since the adjetivos possessivos do not agree with the gender, this is the only solution, right? And also, you can use today's topic, and that's why I bring this idea here, right? So you can use any of the adjetivos demostrativos that I present to you. So you can say, estos estudiantes. But if you do that, you are eliminating the rest of the possibilities. That's what you are choosing. You can say also, estas estudiantes, right? You can also say esas, because there is no clarity about the distance. You can say esas, you can say esos as well. And you can even say aquellos or aquellas. All those are possibilities that you can select. I hope that you find this interesting. I hope that you also find it something that is not difficult to control, difficult to manage. And with this topic, you can advance in controlling the language, producing the language on your own, little by little, right? Step by step. And remember my mantra, practice, practice, and practice. There is no other recipe to progress in learning a foreign language. And when you go to my channel, subscribe into that. So long for now.